Welcome back to We Mean Business. 5 years ago, Steve Jobs introduced the iPhone to the world. The first iPhone went on sale exactly 5 years ago, on the 29th of June 2007. And since then, Apple has shipped 250 million iPhones worldwide, generating $150 billion in cumulative revenues. On the show today, on the iPhone's fifth birthday, we ask, is the iPhone one of the biggest success stories in recent history? And will it continue to break its own records? Joining me on the show today, Rajat Agrawal, Executive Editor of BGR India, with us here in the studio, and also Kishore Bhargava, well-known technology mentor. Thank you both for joining us on the show. But before we start our discussion, Ashutosh Sinha tells us the iPhone story and the battle that's being fought between Apple and its rivals.
Shweta, this is a business battle being fought around the world in courtrooms, at the marketplace, among the developer community, and on technology platforms as well. 5 years ago, when Apple launched the iPhone, the smartphone market was ready for a takeoff. Samsung was among the world's top electronic good companies and was also one of the biggest partners for Apple. In 2011, Apple purchased nearly $8 billion worth of products from Samsung. But the story has changed from Apple being one of Samsung's biggest customers. The two were now the biggest rivals in the smartphone market. And numbers do the talking. Of nearly 400 million smartphones sold in the world last year, Apple and Android phones cornered over 80% of the market. The battle during 2011 was clearly between American company Apple and the Asian giant Samsung. The heat was felt by the Finnish giant Nokia, which has issued a second profit warning in 2012. 10,000 jobs have been cut. That has been announced by Nokia earlier this month. And the Finnish giant has also lost nearly $80 billion in market value since the launch of iPhone in 2007. Moody's recently has downgraded Nokia's debt to junk status. And everyone is now wondering if it's actually connecting with people at all or not. Now, let me tell you what is happening with the other giant, Canadian smartphone giant Research in Motion, the makers of popular BlackBerry brand, has been hit even harder. Shipment of its BlackBerry phones fell from 13 million in 2010 to 9.9 million last year. The market share nearly halved to 6.9% in 2011. And it's actually the Android powered phones and the Apple's iOS which dominate the market. And numbers clearly show that. The other smartphone makers which have rapidly been losing market share could easily be dismissed as, well, call them a case of rotten apples for the moment. So of the 150 million smartphones sold during the first quarter this year, Android phones backed by Google's operating system and Apple accounted for 82% of the sales. RIM's BlackBerry accounted for a measly 6.4% market share. Android-powered phones are seeing a meteoric rise in sales and Apple is following very closely behind. The others, well, do they matter at all? Sales for mobile phones will grow at about 7% during 2012, and smartphone sales will slow down, but imagine, Shweta, they'll still grow at 39%. So finally, Shweta, in our device-driven world of today, here's what we could look at. You could sip some apple juice from a Google Glass on a Microsoft Surface and stare at the Samsung Galaxy. And after all this, you can't be greedy and ask for an LG chocolate mobile phone, can you?
All right.
Do you have the NDTV Profit app? All the markets, all the news, and your own homemade, ready-made portfolio available there for you.
We will right now answer what you should sell, what you should buy when markets are down.
Download at ndtvprofit.com/apps. Get the best app from the channel you trust.